Now to reaction in Pakistan. For that, we go to NewsHour special correspondent Saima Mohsin in Abbottabad, Pakistan. Jeffrey Brown spoke with her a short time ago.
Saima, welcome. Tell us a little bit more about the situation there at the compound right now, and also a bit more about the town itself.
Well, the compound has tonight been sealed and cordoned off. This is as close as we can get to it. It's about 1,000 meters down this road, and I don't know if you can see the police officers behind me who are patrolling up and down, making sure that no media can get through any closer to see it. We are hoping to get closer to it tomorrow, but as it stands tonight, it's been sealed off. We understand the body has been taken away. And just to give you a sense of exactly where we are in the city, Abbottabad is actually a holiday resort. A lot of people retire here, people have summer houses here. It's in a hilly area in Pakistan, in the north of Pakistan. It's very picturesque. It's quite a sleepy town, really. So a lot of amazement that amongst their midst was Osama bin Laden. And, of course, the irony that you can't walk 100 meters or so without seeing a military installation here.
Well, so you've had a chance to talk to people today. Tell us a little bit about you. Say they were surprised. What were they saying to find out about this?
Complete shock and amazement. I met one gentleman who lives only a few doors down from this house. He literally drove past it every day on the way to work and said he had absolutely no idea that Osama bin Laden could be his neighbor. He did say that the compound seemed strange. It was a very unusual structure, much larger than any other house along this neighborhood from what I've seen so far too. And of course, the high walls we've been hearing about and footage we've seen is also unusual. However, as is often the case in Pakistan, he said to me, there are some very rich people who do own a lot of land and might have just sealed it off for privacy. So we asked no more questions. We just assumed that it was someone who'd moved into the neighborhood. But complete shock and amazement that in a place like Abbottabad, and of course, in a place with such heavy military presence, Osama bin Laden could have been living here.
Now, here in the U.S., of course, there is a lot of discussion about how bin Laden could have lived there without anyone knowing, particularly any authorities. Is that discussion taking place there in Pakistan as well?
Yes, it most certainly is. These questions are being echoed right here in Abbottabad and, of course, right across Pakistan. How could he have been in the midst of this city with people living right next door to him and not knowing that he was there or reporting that there was a strange activity, perhaps? But more so, the irony of the fact that this is a place where there are a lot of military installations. As I said, you can't walk 100 paces without seeing a combined military hospital. There is, of course, just a few hundred meters away, the famous Karkul Pakistan Military Academy as well. So it's peppered with military installations. It's almost as though he was right under the military's nose and no one knew about it.
So what is the official reaction or response from the government and from the military at this point? What are they saying?
Again, a little bit of shock here that there hasn't been any official word from the military. They have kept quiet on this. I understand there was a very high-profile meeting this morning with the intelligence agencies, the police, and various members of the military to discuss this operation conducted directly by U.S. forces in the early hours of Monday morning and Sunday night. However, no official statement coming from the military. There has been a statement from the Foreign Office, however, emphasizing that this was an intelligence-led operation, perhaps alluding to the fact that the Pakistani intelligence agencies did help the United States get to Osama bin Laden. However, making it very clear in this carefully worded statement that it was United States forces that conducted the operation, in what has always been U.S.-led policy, that they will go directly to get Osama bin Laden dead or alive.
And to that point, are you hearing any anger expressed or frustration or whatever word you pick expressly about that it was a U.S. military operation in Pakistan?
Well, as news of his death is starting to sink in here in Pakistan, as it is right across the world, the questions are now starting to be asked. How is it that he was here in Abbottabad? How is it that U.S. forces themselves came onto Pakistani soil? We've heard that turn of phrase so many times. Boots on the ground are unacceptable. Pakistan's sovereignty should not be breached. And, of course, officials will always perhaps come out and say it is unacceptable. But as we've seen with the drone attacks, the Pakistani people feel that perhaps officials turn a blind eye to this. And local people are saying this to me today, that it couldn't be possible that they didn't know about it. However, this is the sentiment here. There is anger that United States felt that it could come right directly onto Pakistani soil.
And briefly, Saima, there was a warning from the Pakistani Taliban today that there would be some kind of response. Is that being taken seriously there?
It most definitely is. Of course, Pakistan has been a victim and suffered itself many terrorist attacks at the hands of Al-Qaida, the Pakistani Taliban, and other extremist groups inspired by Osama bin Laden. And yes, there is a fear of a backlash, even more so now as splinter groups perhaps come out seeking revenge in smaller pockets up and down the country. And we have seen a reaction to that in terms of people saying that more police vigilance is needed, and the public needs to be more aware of this.
All right, Saima Mohsin in Pakistan. Thanks very much.
Thank you.